hair. It comes in many different colors, textures, lengths, shades, types, and cuts. My hair personally is very fine, very straight, but I could grow quite a bit of it. My hair is naturally type 1A. It's very straight, very fine, and has no hint of wave or curl. My hair naturally sits at about a 6'7". Obviously, it darkened over the years as I aged, but also I had about 10 years of jet black box dye on it. And then I walked into the salon and decided to go blonde. In one day. I also added some extensions, which caused quite a bit of damage, especially because I wasn't the greatest at taking care of them when I took them out during COVID. And then I decided to DIY my roots at home, which was the biggest mistake that I could have ever made. My hair was snapping, falling out, breaking at the crown. These are extensions that you see here. Like, my whole head was fried. I completely burnt off all of my hair. I was left with about six pieces of hair, literally six pieces of hair. Do you see that? It's see-through. So I feel like a lot of people do this exact same thing and they just go back dark. I added some extensions to cover up all of my issues, but I needed to fix the root of the problem, literally. Then it was about January and the hairdressers had shut down because we had gone into our second or third lockdown. I don't even remember. So I had to take the extensions out because they were just damaging my hair and I had to fix the issue, which left me with no hair and not a lot of confidence. In this video, you can literally see my extensions balding me. So when I took these bad boys out, I was left with even less hair than before, which I didn't think was even possible. But I had no hair on my head. And I even had to cut quite a bit off. Like, it would stick up because it was so dead and so damaged and so broken at the crown. Like, it was insane, which triggered my obsession with hair and hair talk and figuring out the quickest and best way to grow my hair fast, which led me to this journey. So over the last 10 months, I have just researched, documented, and tried to figure out the best method to grow your hair. So without further ado, let's get into it.
Okay, so I just got out of the shower. This is the current state of my hair. I'm filming on my phone so that way I have date stamps, basically. I feel like a little boy. Even though I've had this type of hair before, I just feel like a little boy. I don't know how to describe it, but it's also really thin, so that's why I'm feeling like a little boy. I also cut a shit ton off. So this is basically the only healthy hair I have right now. Well, actually, honestly, it's only like this part up here that's healthy. And then this, it's like not dead, but it's not that healthy as well. Like, it's still, it's okay. Like, it's repairable. So it's currently mid-January. I'll pop up the date right here, but I just wanted to film this on my phone. That way I have dates of exact times and everything. So yeah, this is what we're starting off at. We're starting fresh because girl had extensions in, and extensions are hella damaging. I would have hair down to my ass, so healthy and strong right now if I didn't go blonde, short, dark, short, long extensions in a span of 6 months. But I did that. So now I'm back in quarantine. So I was like, you know what? I might as well start to get healthy again behind the ears. But like in front, I don't like this. These need to grow. So we're gonna keep it behind the ears for now.
You, I don't want you to have anyone, and if you don't want me, there's something wrong with them, right? Maybe I got problems that I don't tell anyone. Have I lost my perception? Feel like I wanna do something wrong now. Packing all your belongings, say you wanna take some time, but if
it feels super thick right now on top after I started using this for a few days even. But it's feeling really good, which is crazy because it's only been a few weeks. Like, it feels so much better than when I first chopped it off, which is crazy. Wow.
Do I go move around very much when I sleep. Okay, so I'm ready to go to bed now. You guys, today is Monday and it's the first day of week four. This is the technique from the Japanese show. So basically you're doing like
okay, it is currently the end of February. It's February 25th. There's only like two more days of February, three more days of February. 26th? I don't even know. But this is the current state of my hair. It is so healthy on top. I've been using castor oil. I've been using castor oil like every other day. I've been using this Ordinary on my scalp and I've been just masking the shit out of it with this. Castor oil mask as well, and then I use Olaplex shampoo, conditioner, and all of their treatments as well, and my hair is starting to get so much thicker at the root. I am finally starting to see a difference. Like, I'm finally to feel like finally feeling like it's almost starting to be wearable. So I'm pretty excited about it because my biggest thing was like the front pieces here were so sparse that I wasn't able to wear it, so they're slowly growing. I don't know, I feel like if I put a side by side of the very first video 2 months ago or a month and a half ago compared to now, you'll be able to see a really big difference, and I can feel such a big difference as well, which is the biggest part of it. I'm not sure if I'm gonna have to like trim again, but I am starting to see such like so much progress. Like, these bangs are getting so much longer than they were at first, and even my hair in general is starting to get so much thicker and just feels stronger and healthier. So definitely what I've been doing is working. Like, these were not here before. Like, I just need this part to grow basically, and then I will feel much more confident in wearing my hair down, because I can wear it like this, I feel like right now it's fine, but in the middle part it's just not looking so hot because I'm so sparse, but I can definitely start to wear it down soon, so I'm really excited about it. But yeah, things are looking up. Like, this is so much longer than what it used to be, so I'm really, really pumped about it. We're making progress, ladies and gentlemen. Slowly but surely. It's been a month and a half and I feel like you can see much better here. Like, the health of my hair like is just so much better, and like, we're getting all these, like, this is how much it's just growing really, really quickly. Like, you can see my natural hairline is coming through. It's very light, but a lot of growth, and it's starting to almost be wearable. I do look like a little bit of a mushroom, but I think styled properly, I would be able to get away with it. Let's see what it looks like from the back if I can stand up. So this is what it looks like from the back. This will be good for a thumbnail, so let's just do that. But we're making so much progress. Like, do you guys see how healthy my hair looks? Like, so shiny, and that is great news. The bottoms, I'm not sure if I'm gonna have to like trim, but I'm gonna wait till I go to the actual hairdressers to see what happens. But things are happening. It's getting thicker. Exactly, it's so sleek and smooth, which I love. So I didn't think this was ever going to be possible again, but we are making progress. It feels so healthy. Like, for the first time in a long time, my hair feels not like straw. Progress. It just feels so good. Like, I needed to do that chop. It finally got rid of the last like dead pieces, and now it's time to grow. Like, look at the shine. Yes. These are all new baby hairs too. Like, this was not here before. Even though I still look like a mushroom, but progress, okay? Progress. We got a pimple. Just trying to, like, you know. Progress, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, this is what we're at now. Okay, here's a hair update. It's actually starting to be wearable. Like, it's thick. It's starting to be thicker. I'm so happy with the progress. The only thing I don't like is this part right here. But this side is definitely starting to be wearable. I could definitely wear it like this, and it's like really wearable. If I just like put it all to one side almost. I had like castor oil, I had all my old oils in it. So this is like what happens after I do it. Plus like a treatment. You can see all the growth here for sure. You can see how much, like you can kind of see like the difference of how much it's actually grown. It looks scary. Like that much craziness. Lots of baby hairs coming through. The oils, the castor oil, and the Olaplex, and the ordinary hair oil is definitely working for me. For a better, for everybody's sake. This is what we're dealing with. Bouncy and it's healthy. That's the most important thing, is that it's freaking finally healthy. Now I'm gonna go bleach it again. But I'm so happy with the way that it's coming along. So you can see all that hair growth right there. That's a lot of growth. It's grown this much in the last 6 months. That's crazy. That's crazy. It's healthy. She cute. My finished look. I'm obsessed.
Why hasn't he called me back? It's been 3 days. Stalking his Instagram, saying he's in a phase. it's jealousy, but hell with it, still look a melody. Or maybe I got problems that I don't tell anyone. Have I lost my perception? Feel like I wanna do something wrong now. 10, 9, counting down, putting on a smile. 8, 7, 6, 5, you say goodbye, lock the door, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pain inside, don't wanna feel it. So I pour up inside my cup and I just sip till I can't feel it. I know it won't solve my problem, but I know it makes a difference. One more sip and I'ma face it. Out my body when I'm tempted. I told her one more, she hear me say you quit or she dipping.
Yeah. I don't want pain no more. I don't want no more pain. I ain't gon' see no way. Look at that window pane. See the rain coming down, but it is not purple today. Came a long way from stacking and rolling that change. And all I ever wanted was some real love. Then I.
Okay, here's my final check-in. It's been officially 10 months. It is the beginning of November. It's November 4th today, or the 3rd today. So this is my final check-in before I'm going to post this video. If it looks a little bit shorter, it's because I trimmed it a few days ago. Just because, you know, I'm constantly trimming because I want to get rid of all the old dead hair. And obviously your hair breaks quicker than it grows. So if you get rid of all the split ends, it will grow quicker without breaking off, because it will just break and break and break and break and break and break. And that's probably why your hair isn't growing if you're not trimming it. So that's kind of what I did. So you might not have seen my hair grow too much in this whole entire process lengthwise, but it definitely got a lot healthier. And you know, those pieces that used to stick up fall down now, which is the biggest key. They've also grown a lot. They were literally up to here at one point, so they have grown down to here, which is insane. And I have restored and revived my hair. It is no longer see-through like it used to be. I don't have 6 pieces of hair. Obviously I don't have the thickest hair in the world, and it's still getting healthier, but I am so proud of my progress with everything that I've done. And I'm gonna tell you guys all the steps that I took to get my hair back to this in 10 months, because 10 months in the grand scheme of things is not a lot of time. So I'm pretty proud with the way my hair has turned out, and we're gonna get into all the things that I changed in my life right now, and all the products that I use, and everything I did to get to this back to this healthy point. So without further ado, let's get into how I healed my hair.
Okay, the first and most important part of hair growth is the health of your overall body, making sure you're eating the right foods, drinking enough water, and making sure that you're addressing any health problems, which should be talked about with your doctor if you're feeling any certain type of way that you think is affecting your hair. For me personally, that was not an issue. My issue was the fact that I over bleached, over processed, and put extensions in my hair. drinking water, eating the right foods are obviously very important for the health of your hair and the growth of your hair, but I'm going to talk to you guys about some health products that you can add to your everyday routine that actually were game changers for my hair. So I started drinking this Vital Proteins collagen in my coffee every single morning. I started about 7 months ago, and this is when I started to see such a difference in my hair. So collagen can directly promote hair follicle growth through amino acids and proteins. And since I just drink my coffee every day, it honestly wasn't the biggest issue in adding this to my everyday routine, and it gives my creamer a little bit more flavor. You can get like vanilla and many different flavors. Okay, next up we have vitamins. I just want to say a disclaimer, I'm not a doctor, so please consult your doctor before adding any of these vitamins into your daily routine. But about a year ago, I started taking these vitamins daily, and I do think that it has made my hair so much healthier, and I just know that I'm getting all these vitamins, and that way I'm not lacking anything in my body, which I think is very important for hair growth. It doesn't necessarily make your hair growth, but it can help aid in some hair growth and making sure your hair is growing healthy. You can also eat the right foods, and you can get all these vitamins through the right diet. I personally am a very go-go-go person, so I just like to get it over in the morning and take all my vitamins. Working out is also the biggest key when it comes to hair growth. I saw the biggest change in my hair when I started working out on a daily basis. About 3 months ago, I started working out really hard every day, and I saw the biggest change in my hair. Okay, next, let's stop with the DIY hair products or hair situations. I tried the rice water for a little bit, and honestly, I'm not sure if it helped at all. So I think we should just stick to like salon grade products or really well reviewed products, because if you try too many of these things, they could actually cause more damage than helping your hair. So I just suggest to just stay away from them. Also, limit your hair washing to 1 to 2 times a week. I know some people might think that this is a crazy thing, and a lot of people are like, my hair gets too greasy to only wash it twice a week, but you're probably just not washing your hair correctly. Make sure to emulsify your shampoo, which is like literally rubbing your hands together for about 10 to 20 seconds to really get it spread out. It heats it up, then it distributes it well onto your scalp. That way it gets rid of all of the residue from all your products and all the buildup, therefore clarifying your scalp correctly, and your hair won't get greasy as quickly. Adding dry shampoo before your hair gets oily, not after, will also help reduce oil. And make sure to hit your hair with a double cleanse. That means you're shampooing your hair 4 times a week, but you're only washing your hair twice. So every time you shower, every time you wash your hair, you're shampooing your scalp twice. The first cleanse works hard to remove these residues, which include dead skin cells, natural oils, and atmospheric pollutants, while the second one completely eliminates them and boosts hair health. Another major tip is to add silk everything, silk bonnets, silk pillowcase, silk scrunchies instead of hair elastics. These will not pull or tug at your hair. And on top of that, invest in a microfiber hair towel. They literally have them on Amazon for like $12 to $15. I'm pretty sure you probably could even find one at the dollar store, to be completely honest. But this is such a game changer because it doesn't tug, rip at your hair. It's very gentle, and it also helps to dry your hair in a nice, timely manner. Okay, my next major tip is if you're going through something that I was going through, you need to invest in some sort of hair ponytail or these hair buns right here, which were such a game changer for me. You just tie it on top of your little crusty little bun that you have, and it gives your hair such a different look. You look more full, and I got one in blonde too. This was literally such a major key for me, for my confidence. Also, these ponytails. I got so many of these ponytails that just helped out, and also these wigs, another ponytail I literally invested. And while you're asleep, make sure you're tying your hair up in a very loose bun or a loose braid, something very protective, and try your best to stay away from sleek hairstyles like this. Next tip is to get trims and dustings every few months. I know a lot of people are afraid of this type of situation because they're like, oh, you're just cutting more hair off, but your hair is actually going to snap off quicker than it's going to grow, and those split ends are going to travel up your hair shaft and just break off, and you're literally going to see no results. So just do a big chop, a small chop every once in a while. Okay, here are my products and my shower routine. This is what I have done for the last 10 months. First up is Olaplex. You've probably heard this 1,000 times in every video, but it is true. It works literal wonders. I've used this whole entire set 2 times a week for the first 5-ish months, and now once a week. I use the shampoo and conditioner 2x a week when I wash my hair, obviously. But this has been such a game changer. It's expensive, a little bit expensive. You just don't get a lot of product, but honestly, it has been a game changer and a lifesaver for me. It has some special technology, and there I am emulsifying it, of course. And it has literally worked wonders on my hair. So I highly, highly recommend using it. These are the hair masks that I have been using. So Shea Moisture. Also, I'm literally always have a hair mask in my hair, I swear. But especially at the beginning, I always had a hair mask in my hair. These are four of my favorites. Two are Shea Moisture and then Whey. And the Olaplex one, of course. Shea Moisture is a little bit more inexpensive. These are leave-in conditioners, but honestly, they're a little bit too heavy for leave-in conditioners for me, so I use them as a mask. But if you have thicker hair, I definitely suggest using them as leave-in conditioners. Okay, oils. This, like, if you're not putting oil on your hair, you need to start yesterday. The Unite and the Kerastase and the Olaplex especially, I typically will just mix them all together and put them in my hair literally every day on the ends, and then pretty much after I'm getting closer to my wash day, I'll start to move on up my hair. But I'm literally always using oils and hyaluronic acid, also major key. I've started to use that recently as well. Okay, these little tools. I started getting this hair massager probably 2 months ago. I got it, and it has actually, I've seen such a difference since using it. I will put oil on my head closer to my wash day, and I will massage the crap out of my head, and it just feels good, and I think it works. It definitely stimulates hair growth. I also got one of these derma rollers. I have not seen results yet because I just started using it, but it's also something you could look into if you're interested. Okay, shampoo and conditioner. So obviously, guys, I told you guys about Olaplex. It is my go-to as my one cleanse, but for my double cleanse, I use anti-residue shampoo by Neutrogena. I use this once a week, and this gets rid of all of the residue and buildup and just leaves my scalp so clean and healthy and ready for fresh hair growth. And then the Fenola has been the least damaging purple shampoo that I've found. Okay, moving on to scalps and scrubs. Of course, your hair health starts at your scalp. So if you have residue and leftover buildup on your scalp, your hair is not going to grow. So using scalp scrubs are very important. These are a few of my favorite. Okay, leave-in conditioner. I do not ever brush my hair without putting on leave-in conditioner, wet, dry, no matter what. I am always spraying this stuff in my hair because I only have so much hair left and I need to kind of keep as much as I can without pulling it out with my hairbrush. So I will brush my hair with my wet brush and my wide tooth comb, and I will gently brush from the bottom to the top, especially when it's wet. I'm very gentle with my hair. So I'll start with my wide tooth comb, and then I will move on to my wet brush. And then I move into my holy grail mixture, which is my Olaplex number 6 and 7, I think it is. I mix these two together, I emulsify them, mix them all up in my hands, and I put them on my hair, focusing on my ends mainly because that's where my hair is the most dry, of course. Stay away from the scalp because if you just shower, you don't want to get too greasy and oily too quickly, and you'll do that by putting too much product on your scalp. Of course, wait a few days to put oil on your scalp again. And then I will go in with some more oil on my ends, which is my Kerastase and my Unite hair oil, which is, they're literally, mwah, mwah. I love them so much. They literally have been such a life changer. Again, of course, they're argan oil. Stick to argan oil, I promise you. And then I'm good to go, except we got to blow dry. And I know a lot of times it's like, stay away from heat. Well, try not to flat iron your hair to death, but actually blow drying your hair isn't the worst thing for it. This is actually a common myth that people think that blow drying is the worst thing for your hair, and actually it's not. I personally invested in this Drybar blow dryer brush, and honestly, this has been such a life changer. I love it so much. There's obviously better ones like the Dyson, or probably cheaper ones as well. You just have to do your research. But blow drying your hair is actually not bad if done right. It's actually a pretty common myth. Air drying your hair could actually do more harm than good, and buying a good quality blow dryer is key. Even one with a cool setting, a medium heat, and a hot setting is also very important. Blow drying your hair root to tip can help seal the hair cuticle, which helps prevent damage. Air drying allows moisture to remain on your head too long, which isn't good. And over drying your hair can cause damage, so finding a happy medium is the best thing to do for your hair. So the best method is to air dry 70% and then blow dry the rest. And do not over dry your ends. And also use a heat protectant, which is what I use in the Olaplex oil mixture that I had previously, actually doubles as a heat protectant. But these are all the steps that took me from this to finally healthy hair in just under a year. I hope you guys enjoyed my little hair journey. This took a little while to edit and film, so I hope you guys really enjoyed it. If you want more videos like this, please let me know. And thank you so much for watching. And don't forget to subscribe. I love you guys so much, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!